أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي كان موجودا قبل حدوث الأشياء ويبقى بعد فناء الأشياء، تفرد بالأولية والقدم وبسم كل شيء ما عداه بالفناء والعدم، كما قال عز شأنه: كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه، وكل نفس ذائقة الموت، وقال: كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنام سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله في كتابه الكريم: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان. صلوات. After several weeks, we are going to resume our topic that we were discussing before Muharram. As you know, that our discussion for many years in Khutbah al-Jum'ah is Risalat al-Huquq, the treatise on rights of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salatu wasalam. In this excellent discourse on rights, Imam has mentioned around 50 various rights that we have to consider and we have to pay in our life. And this is very amazing booklet, very important message, and a great discourse on very important topic, and it is system of rights in Islam. So we are discussing this system of rights, which starts with paying the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the rights of ourselves and the rights of other people. So Imam has categorized the rights into three categories. One, Allah's rights. The second, our own rights on ourselves, and then rights of people on ourselves. Rights of Allah, that we have to always keep in our mind, is the essence of religion. And based on that right of Allah, we have to know that there are rules and laws, there are some relationships that we have with other things and other people in our life, and every single relationship establishes a system of rights and responsibilities. So the rights of other things and other people are originally responsibilities and duties from our side. So it is our obligation and it is our duty to pay the rights of other things and other people. Other things like ourselves, our hands, our eyes, our ears. So we discussed this in previous khutbahs with details. Anything that belongs to us, since we say it belongs to us, mine, my hand, for example, my eyes. So how I should use my eyes? How should I use my hands? I have to know that. Because my hands have rights on me. My eyes have rights on me. All my body organs and body parts have rights on myself. And myself has a rights on myself. Me, myself. So we discussed that in details. We are not going to go again. Then Imam starts with the rights of others. So rights of Allah, rights of ourselves, then rights of other things and other people on us. So any single relationship that we have with anyone has a rights, has rules and laws how to deal with that thing or with that person. The person may be our very close relative. It can be a stranger in both situations, how to deal with people. The person can be our friend. He can be our enemy. Still, how to deal with them. It's amazing. Rules and laws mentioned in this book of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, who is our fourth Imam. Until we reach to right number 49. There are 50 rights mentioned in this book. So we discuss all those 49 rights, and you will be amazed by hearing this. That last year, the whole year, we discussed only one right and we did not finish it yet. Single right in every Friday, but we did not finish that single right. What was that? حَقُّ أَهْلِ مِلَّتِكَ. The rights of the people of your creed, means your community, the people who share with you their faith and creed. They believe the same as you do. So they have some commonalities with you in faith. They are your community. Those people have rights on you. And we discussed this the whole year. And now we are again resuming the same discussion, of course, from the place where we left. We are not going to discuss what we have discussed already. No repetition. We don't need to. Why? Because all those khutbahs are there on the internet available, mashallah. And some people are writing those and sending them by emails. So, where we left? We left on the point when Imam was saying that, listen, the rights of your community members is one of the rights is that you have to be thankful to the person. Of course, there are three types of people when he mentioned, just to connect and relate to our previous discussion, to give you the brief. What Imam has said, that there are three types of people in your community. One, who is your close friend, or the person who helps you, gives you favors. The other person who insults you, who is your, you know, maybe against you, maybe your enemy. He wants to harm you, or at least musi'ihim, the person who is not good with you. So the person who is good with you, this is one. The second, the one who is not good with you. But there is a third person. Who is he? He is the person who is neither good with you nor bad. He's a person, just you saw him in the mosque. He said, Salaamu Alaikum. He said, Alaikum Assalam. You don't know him much. Or even though if you know him, but he is neither your very close friend, he neither did anything good to you, neither he was bad with you ever. How to deal with such people? So Imam says, you have to thank him. He deserves your gratitude. For what? Why should I thank him? He did not do anything good with me. He did not give me any favor. So I say thank you for that. You don't have to say thank you, but you have to be thankful for such a person. The reason is that this person, at least, why he deserves your gratitude, that he did not harm you. And this is great. Why? Because when he is part of your community, you see him, right? You meet him. He is not among those people who cause any harm to you. This is enough. That he's not harming me. Thank you. Right? So he gave three reasons. One of them is وَكَفَاكَ مَأُونَتَهُ. And we stopped here last in our last khutbah in Dhul Hijjah, before Muharram. In this khutbah, if you remember, we talked on this particular word that Imam used, وَكَفَاكَ عَنْهُ وَكَفَاكَ مَأُونَتَهُ. This person, one of his qualities that for which he deserves your gratitude is that he is a person who is not becoming burden on you. Right? Burden on you. He is not coming even ask. First of all, he is not harming you. He is not causing any harm to you. There is a person who is not causing harm to you, but he is coming for help. Every time he is coming for help to you. To feel that he is burden. He is not becoming burden on you. Here, what we discussed was very important. And I have to go through it again. In brief, and inshallah discuss more about this very important topic. When Imam says that he is not becoming burden on you, what does this mean? So simply, you know, someone who is coming to me and asking me for help, is he burden on me? So remember, in a couple of sermons, we discussed that no, the person who is coming to me, asking me for help, he is not burden for me. Rather, he is rahmat, mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saqahu ilayk. This is hadith of Rasulullah. This is Allah's mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has driven this mercy towards you. This mercy could go somewhere else. So there are two types of mercies from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we receive. One is general mercy, one is special mercy. In one sense, Allah is Rahman. Why? Because His mercy reaches everyone. Everyone with no discrimination. The second, He is Rahim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Rahim. So He is compassionate, He is merciful for very specific people, not for everybody. So there, He has two types of mercies. One mercy reaches to everyone, and one special mercy, special Allah's bounties that reaches to special people. This person who is coming, asking you for help, this is a special mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Special among special mercies, special among special bounties. Why special among special? Because he is coming to ask you for help. He could go somewhere else. Allah had driven him. Saqahu ilayk. Look what the hadith say, the tradition, you know, the saying of the Prophet. He says, this is a mercy. So mercy is coming, right? 50 people are sitting here. One mercy is coming. A special mercy of Allah. It's coming, coming, coming. He can go to him, to him, to him. But he came to you. Why? Because Allah sent him to you. Why? Because Allah loves you. Allah loves you. Allah likes you. Allah likes that this special mercy should go to your account. Now, if you reject this mercy, so you're rejecting Allah's special bounty. What is this mercy? This mercy is a person who is coming asking help from you. So how can this person be a burden? A person who is becoming Allah's mercy or embodiment of Allah's mercy, his coming to you is a mercy of Allah. So how can he become a burden? Why then Imam says, at least he is not becoming burden on you. He is not bothering you with asking for help. Because of course, if he's going to ask you for help, you are going to spend your time, spend your money, spend your energy, planning, many, you know, go through so much in order to fulfill his need that he, you know, is expecting from you. So why Imam should say that he is not burden you? Okay, the reason is here. Islam is a religion which always speaks of about two sides. In any kind of relationship, there are two sides. There is no rule or no law in Islam which is just one way. You will never find Islam's talking about, addressing only husband. Husband should do this. No. Both. Husband should do this and wife should do this. Parents, this is their rights. And children, this is their rights. Two way. Everything in any relationship, both have responsibilities and both have rights. It's never one way. The same here. When Imam says, at least he is not becoming burden on you, he means there are two ways, two rights. One, the person who is coming asking for help, he has been discouraged in Islam to ask for help. All of us, all of you, have been discouraged in Islam. Don't ask for help. Don't, you know, especially begging is totally discouraged. And I gave you the reference in the whole Quran, more than 6,000 ayat and verses in the whole Quran, and how much Quran encouraging, about the, you know, giving the charity and giving alms. So much. Everywhere, whenever Allah speaks about salat, about prayers, speaks about zakat. Pray to Allah and give charity to people. Both goes hand in hand. In the whole Quran. Give charity. Give charity. Help people. Right? But in no place, Quran says, go and seek zakat. Seek charity. Go get charity from somebody. In the whole Quran, you will never find a single ayat about this. So why Allah is saying, give, but never says go and take. Why? Because Allah is discouraging us to be burden on other people. So this is for us, for a person who try to ask or who is in need. Try to avoid asking people for help as much as you can. Unless you really are totally helpless and you have to, then of course it's not haram, it's not forbidden. That's why it's not haram. Remember, This is the beauty of Islam, Islamic laws. We have to understand what Islam is. Discouraging doesn't mean forbidden. There are five words, and each word has its own meaning. Wajib, haram, mustahab, makruh, and mubah. Obligatory, forbidden, recommended, discouraged, and allowed. Five. So asking is not haram, but totally discouraged. Don't ask someone. Why? Because of course you are going to be burdened to him. You are going to take his time, you are going to take his money, or anything you are asking, he is going to remain in stress and tension until he fulfills your need. So you're putting him in such a position that he may be not comfortable with it. So don't try to be burden on somebody. From your side, the person who is asking, who is in need, he should think that I am burden if I'm asking. Here is what Imam is referring to. But you, the person who is being asked for help, if somebody is coming to you to ask for help, that person should think by himself that I am becoming a burden to my friend, to my brother. But you, the brother and the friend, you never think that he is a burden. Think that he is a mercy of Allah driven to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See the balance? Here is the balance. So you always try not to be burden on others, but you never think that somebody who's coming to you for help, he is burden on you. Rather, you welcome him as you welcome a mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the whole idea behind what Imam is saying, that at least he is not becoming burden on you. وَكَفَاكَ عَنْهُ عَنْكَ مَأُونَتَهُ. Then we, if you remember, we discussed few ahadith and few ayat from Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his prophet and Allah's appointed leaders and fallible leaders, imams, have taught us how to help people and how they have encouraged. Look, asking for help is discouraged, but helping people is highly, highly recommended and encouraged. How much it is encouraged? There are many ahadith about it. There are many, not just ahadith, we don't just see. Look, one of the unique features of Islam is this, that Islamic leaders don't only speak, they practice and show you. Our prophet and our imams, they don't only give us instructions, do this and do that. No. Even before they say it, they practice it and show us. So we cannot say, okay, how can somebody do this? They help people. Look, you might say, look, I, of course, don't feel and don't consider somebody who's coming to me for help as a burden. But he's asking me in such a situation, in such a position when I don't have anything or I don't, I'm not able to help him, for example. So I don't like somebody to ask me because he is just bothering me by his request for help. No. When you don't have anything and he is coming to ask you and then you try, this has more thawab and reward than when you have and helping somebody. فِي السَّرَّاءِ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Those who spend in the way of Allah, فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. When they are in ease, they have money, they are able to help. والضراء, and where they are not able to help, still they're trying to help. So Ahlul Bayt showed how it is possible. For three continuous days, they helped the person, the people who were asking for help, and they gave them their own bread, and they remained hungry for 3 days. They didn't eat the bread and gave it to the person who said, I am hungry. So if you are hungry, you eat it. We'll remain hungry, it's fine. Not for 1 day. The next day, same thing. The third day, the same thing happened. And this is what Quran mentioned, that in the whole surah, Allah revealed in the praise of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. And it was Surah Ad-Dahr. So they practiced that. They said, don't say, okay, if you are hungry, so I cannot do anything because I'm hungry too. And I have one bread. How can I share my bread with you? I will remain hungry. My children will remain hungry. He said, no. They took the bread and gave it to the beggar. And this way they showed that, yes, helping while you are in need is more important than helping when you are able to help and you have a lot of things to give. So never think, even in Ramadan, when the Prophet was saying that giving iftar has this much thawab, somebody said, how can I give, how can I receive this much reward while I am not able to give any iftar? So the Prophet said, fear Allah, اتَّقِ اللَّهُ وَلَوْ بِشِقَّةِ التَّمْرِ وَلَوْ بِشَرْبَةِ مِنَ الْمَاءِ. Don't say that I don't have anything. Even if you have a piece of debt, give it to somebody and you will receive the same reward as somebody is giving a lot of debts and food to someone. Or at least a glass of water. You don't even have that? Don't say I don't have. So never say I don't have anything to help people. Whatever you have, try to do it. Inshallah, we'll continue this and seek some, inshallah, knowledge and advice from our imams and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Salawat Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Inna ahsana al-hadithi wal baghal mu'arada kitab Allah wa a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى يوم الدين. ألا قد أمركم الله في محكم كتابه بالصلاة على نبيه وحبيبه فقال تعليما لكم وتشريفا لصفيه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. وعلى أمير المؤمنين مولانا علي بن أبي طالب. وعلى سيدة نساء العالمين فاطمة بنت رسول الله. وعلى الحسن المجتبى. والحسين الشهيد بكربلاء. وعلي بن الحسين. ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي العسكري اللهم صل على مولانا صاحب الزمان ماحي آثار البدع والطغيان هادم أبنية الشرك والنفاق حاصد فروع الغي والشقاق اللهم عجل فرجه وسهل مخرجه واكحل ناظرنا بنظرة منا إليه واجعلنا ممن يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن عليا ولي الله أشهد أن عليا حجة الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح حي على خير العمل حي على خير العمل قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يسبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض الملك القدوس العزيز الحكيم هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين وآخرين منهم لما يلحقوا بهم وهو العزيز الحكيم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين قل يا أيها الذين هادوا إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس أولياء لله من دون الناس فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم والله عليم بالظالمين قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله أكبر اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا رب صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه واحشرنا معهم الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر بحول الله وقوته أقوم وأقعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين أهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد كذلك الله ربي الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سمع الله لمن حمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم إن عبيدا من عبادك الصالحين قاموا بكتابك وسنة نبيك فاجزهم عنا خير الجزاء الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده يا لطيف ارحم عبدك الضعيف يا ولي العافية أسألك العافية عافية الدنيا والآخرة لي ولجميع المؤمنين رب صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر الحمد لله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته، السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه. أحسنت. بسم الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. استعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين انعمت عليهم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل الله احد. الحمد لله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
salvat par Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Tomorrow morning tafsir will be at 6:30. We'll start with Namaz-e-Fajr at 6:30, and at 7 o'clock we will have tafsir for Surah Araf, ayat number 65 to 67. Then we will have some breakfast. Let me explain you how Maulana does to prepare for this tafsir. He recites about 3 to 4 ayats. He looks at about 8 to 10 tafsir books from Sunni and Shia before he comes, makes notes and come with give the tafsir. So please try to attend at least about once or twice in a month. Please recite Surah Fatiha for all the marhumit of the person who is providing lunch today.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن علي ولي الله أشهد أن عليا حجة الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح حي على خير العمل حي على خير العمل قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر بحول الله وقوته أقوم وأقعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا رب إني مغلوب فانتصر رب صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه واحشرنا معهم الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه الله أكبر
سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
الله أكبر الحمد لله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وتقبل شفاعته في أمته وارفع درجته بحول الله وقوته الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
الله أكبر استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه الله أكبر
سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
الله أكبر بحول الله وقوته أقوم وأقعد الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
الله أكبر استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه الله أكبر
سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده يا لطيف ارحم عبدك الضعيف رب صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه
الله أكبر الحمد لله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر صلى على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم كن لولي الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه Please pray for all mu'minin mu'minat who are sick. and those who need your dua, especially Sister Leila Rizvi Sahiba, Brother Karar Mirza Sahab, and a mu'mina who has a cancer surgery operation today. Her name is Sister Tahseen Fatima. Please pray for her and all mu'minin and mu'minat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them fast recovery and shifa bihaqqi ma'asumi alayhi wa sallam. Recite on Surah Fatiha for all mu'minin and mu'minat and for the marhumin of today's sponsor of Tabarruk. صلى الله عليك يا ابا عبد الله السلام عليك ابن رسول الله السلام عليك وعلى جدك وابيك وعلى امك واخيك وعلى الائمه المعصومين من ولدك وبنيك السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمه الله وبركاته السلام عليك ولا يا غريب الغرباء سلطان علي بن موسى الرضا عليك التحيه والثناء ورحمه الله وبركاته السلام عليك ولا يا صاحب العصر والزمان الأمان 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 السلام عليك يا شريك القرآن السلام عليك يا خليفة الرحمن السلام عليك يا إمام الإنس والجان عجل الله تعالى فرجك وسهل الله مخرجك وظهورك وجعلنا من أعوانك وأنصارك السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. Good night.